This is the Arduino DUE. It's the board for the smart ramps. I'm going to point out a couple of landmarks on it. We have a 32-bit processor. We have spy pins right here. We have an erase button here, a reset button here, a native micro USB port, a programming micro USB port. We have a power supply that we'll probably never use in this tutorial, and that about covers it. I'll be showing you how the smart ramps board looks in just a moment. Okay, to connect these two together, what you want to do is take your female ports and match your male ports from your smart ramps. Apply a little thumb pressure after you've lined them up. And there you go. In a moment, I'll actually show you how to navigate this board and what's on it. This is the smart ramps. It's used on the Arduino DUE board. I'm going to point out a couple of landmarks on the board. We have our pins here for our extruder 0, our pins for extruder 1, our pins for the x-axis, our pins for the y-axis, and then we have two sets of pins for each one of our stepper motors on the z-axis. These ports over here are used for a stepper driver board, as well as these. These are for your x, y, and z. Then we have our end stop pins, which start with the X min and they go all the way up to the Z max. Then we have our I2C pins over here. Then we have what's known as our thermistor pins to help tell temperature. We have T0, T1, and T2 for sets of pins. Then we have our auxiliary 4 pins, our auxiliary 3 pins over here. This also contains pins for your spy pins within here. Then we have our auxiliary 2 pins, our auxiliary 1 pins. Then we have our set of servo pins, a reset button to power cycle. Then we have our VCC pin, our 5 volt pin, and our ground pin. If you jump the VCC and the 5 volt, you'll be able to power the plus rail on your servo pins. Over here, we have two pins for auxiliary 12 volt power. The top one is a positive pin. The bottom one is the negative pin. Then we have our output power over here, which is D10, 9, and 8. This can be used for extruders, fans, or beds, and then possibly other various products that you would like to use. This is our input power supply port right here, and that about covers the board for now. So I'll show you how to load it with the micro USB cable next. Okay, we're gonna load the firmware, but before we do that, we have to connect the USB serial cable. So we're going to look at the ports down here. And what we have is our native and our programming port. So we want to connect to the programming port. And now we're going to connect the other end of the computer, and you're going to hear a beep. Now keep in mind, you don't want to touch any of this area when it's energized. So if there is voltage running through it, do not touch it. In a moment, I'll show you how to load the Marlin firmware. Okay, we're going to open up the Marlin bug fix 2.0.x. This is the development Marlin firmware, which you can find on the Marlin firmware website. We're going to open up the Marlin subfolder. We're going to click on the source folder. We're going to open up the core folder, and then we're going to open up boards.h. Now in boards.h, we're going to search for the smart ramps board. So as you can see, it has the ramps board in it, and it has many other board types. But what we're interested in is the smart ramps configuration, which I believe is up here. So let's search on it. There we go. So what we want is the board underscore ramps underscore smart underscore EFB. So let's copy that. We're going to close out of this file. We're going to go back up to the bug fix folder, go into the Marlin folder, open up marlin.ino. We're going to click on the configuration.h tab where 90% of our configurations are going to take place. We're going to search on motherboard. We're then going to rename board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB, and we're going to put in board underscore ramps underscore smart underscore EFB. And now we're going to check to see that we have the right port selected, which we do. And we have the Arduino programming port selected, which we do. So we're going to click on the upload button. This will compile the software and upload it to the RAMPS. So if you like my video, please press the like and subscribe button. And thank you for your time. And I'll let you see the end of it, compiling and uploading.